Now, following the recent disturbing case which saw two young boys aged 10 and 11 convicted of the attempted rape of an 8-year-old girl, the chairman of the Criminal Bar Association, Paul Mandel, has questioned whether or not the age of criminal responsibility should be raised to 14. He says the current limit of 10 runs the risk of children being prosecuted for crimes that they're simply too immature to understand. He says 10 is awfully young. A child of 10 can know it is doing something wrong and not always appreciate that it's criminally wrong. So, do we agree with him? Should the age of criminal responsibility be raised, do you think?
I think it should. I think it is not right that children between 10 and 14 or young people go into the courts and face a criminal trial. They then have a record. To do things that some young people do, they have to have had such a disturbing life, a life that is we cannot imagine. And the parents need to be brought in. If anyone's going to be prosecuted, they should look to the parents. There has to be investigation, but there has to be a new system for 10 to 14s in a way that can look at what has disturbed them to create.
Well, I think they would probably argue that they already do apply those considerations. I mean, obviously, what we're talking about here isn't just crimes of a sexual nature. This is all crimes of which children of 10 and over are tried, like you say, in an adult court. What do you think, Colin? Is it too much too soon?
I totally disagree, I'm afraid.
Okay.
Purely because I just think, you know, we're talking a 10-year-old. This isn't a 10-year-old. You know, obviously 10-year-olds can get mixed up with the wrong crowds and they can pick a stone up and break a window and blah, 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 and, you know, they get told off for it or whatever. When we're coming to serious crimes, I'm sorry, if they don't know right from wrong, they do know right from wrong at 10, and certainly in this day and age, and yes, it stems from the background, and B, you know, they go, yes, they'll go to court, but they do have all the help there. They have the psychological help. They need to be taken away from the environment they're in, definitely. What I can't bear is they go and then they give them back to these people that don't know how to bring kids up.
But
I think by raising it to 14, what's going to stop them doing it? You know, there's nothing there. They go, oh, it's bad enough now anyway. I mean, if you speak to any policemen, they'll go, well, kids just know that, you know, there's nothing we can do.
But I think what you can't do is generalise that and say all kids are bad.
No,
and,
I'm not saying all kids are bad, but for the ones that are, there has to be some real serious punishment involved. Not, oh, well, they're only 10, never mind.
I suppose the question to be raised is that every child develops at a different rate and a different pace, and what might be a wise and worldly 10-year-old over here on the left, you then presented with a child who is actually quite underdeveloped.
But that's what court's for, to sort that out.
To decide
that.
Should that be an adult court or a child's
court?
But
that's juvenile court. Rehabilitation.
Yeah, that's the world we live in now. We live in a very, very different world. And I think it's quite frightening. And I think if you spoke to a lot of people on the streets, when you get the gangs, there are younger than 10. Mm. And I think people are quite frightened of them as they roam around the streets. Mm. And so that's the world we live in. There has to be some deterrent. Now, if you take it to 14, I think the age between 10 and 14, I know 10, 11-year-olds are, well, very much together, and also they are in these gangs. And I don't think you can change the age, but I think you can change the system that we live in now. And I agree with you, I'm not sure they should go to a criminal court, but surely the system should be changed where there is a court, that there is something that they are frightened of, that they know that they're going to go there if they do something wrong, and something is going to happen to them, and they have to answer to somebody.
I suppose in some cases, for some of these kids, you know, spending time in a juvenile institution is often better than the life that they're being taken from.
Well, that's the other problem.
If they go into an adult court, they have a criminal record. They need major rehabilitation. They need, I know you have to be responsible for what you do, but they need that explained to them, and they also need to find the best form of treatment, because to me, the things that are happening now are sicknesses that are just unbelievable.
But
they need to find a way out.
It's not like they get a criminal record, they're thrown in prison. You know, I mean, maybe the answer is yes, they get a criminal record for a certain amount of time during the rehabilitation, and in some way later on in life, when they get to 18, if they've stayed on the straight and narrow, they can lose the criminal record so it doesn't affect the rest of their life. But I think to just say, you know, we can't do that between 10 and 14, I think we're in danger of just
breeding feral children all over
the place. They're not afraid of anything or anybody. The parents, the police, nothing.
Well, again, that is very general. That is very general, because for every child that will kind of, you know, tart in the face of discipline...
We are speaking of a thousand good ones.
But generally, let us know what you think. It's a hot potato here on the...